What?
Best of one, yeah. Round robin, single round robin. You play each other team one time. Don't hold back on the secrets. Don't hold back on the tricks. Don't hold back on the top lane Urgot, because it just might be the thing that catches your opponents by surprise. Shinny needs to, Envy needs to run back here because there's going to be a fight over this.
All right, the sweeper has just gone out. Brambleback spawns. Redbert, Shinny, and Mikal.
They're rushing down the red
buff. Waiting in the wings now. Red buff is being rushed, as you mentioned. 800 hit points. Smite will be available in just a moment, and it should be secured, and it is. That's the force back from Broxah. That was losing.
Yeah, he's down 10 CS at least for now because it looks like Tactical's pushing the wave. They're going to contest this crab. Shinny doesn't have the E, I believe he's on the crab. He does take it. Looks like it's going to be a fight.
All right, Corja Jane Tactical first to move. They are going to be now surrounded. That's
first.
A route onto Tactical. He's locked up.
The
Flay will buy some time. Teleport coming in from INTZ. Shinny with a fantastic pullback. First blood secured by INTZ. Tactical is flashless, healless, and he is in so much trouble. One last auto, and Tay picks it up.
From Tay, he's going to lose a few creeps, but to watch that again, I think Shinny does have his E coming up soon. He used it on the crab to get the armor off, and then Shinny's running at him because he knows Envy's here first. Envy with the prio comes in. We can see the bot lane from INTZ reacts really well. The TP's coming as well, so Shinny with this flash E was really, really game-changing. Gets the double stun. Tactical has no flash, and then Tay takes him down, and now Tay has a kill, so doesn't make his matchup as hard. He did lose a few creeps, but that's a really big
Jensen
no flash.
The move first. It indicates the plan. Jensen finishes the TP. He's flashless, and the Hex Flash comes in from Shinny. Needs to be able to land the full combo. Jensen's
TP for
out
impact.
Of range, out of vision, and the gold card will connect. Now, Impact making his way with the help of Broxah as well. Envy's bitten off more than he can chew. Impact turns his attention to Shinny, and just like that, he must have that control ward is just taken out there inside.
Out, Jensen,
that's
no flash.
The flash, the engage, the hit bump pulverized, gold card comes out, the unbreakable.
The phase rush, baby.
Phase rush does it for Redbird.
Oh, good...
such dominance.
Oh,
control.
Phase rush.
Headbutt, pulverize, and instantly running away. That was that quick combo that you were talking about, Cadril. But
Shinny's here.
Support. I didn't even see Shinny and Envy. They make their way down. The shockwave catches Tactical, but here comes the Destiny and the gate. Core JJ connects the death sentence, and Envy is sentenced to death.
It ends up always trying to be the first ones as Shinny gets drowsy. The TPs are coming in as well.
Shockwave is still available for Envy. He hasn't pulled the trigger. That's a headbutt coming out. Redbird's going to look for the pulverize. Knocks up Core JJ, but Shinny's already dead. Here comes Tay. He manages to pick up Broxah. Impact has joined the fray in the fight, and that Blade of the Ruined King is wrecking Tay and Redbird's HP. It's
well,
a one.
So they trade one for one overall. That's Mikal and Tactical trading on here.
Yeah, Tactical's going to be so much happier in terms of this fight. No
flash
available to him. Here comes the Destiny. Gold card, insta-cleanse, doesn't matter. Jensen gets the kill.
TL, this 1v1 comp's going to be so strong, and Shinny walks into river. Broxah uses the ult, and then TL just claps first. Core JJ's there first to respond. Double TP's come in, and Broxah does flash away in the end, but Tay chases him down. The Senna ult tries to come out to help it out, but both AD carries weren't really in this fight. It was more of a 4v4 in the end. It was an even trade for both teams.
Because,
but
you know, I remember the golden era, INTZ, when they were playing with Revolta, when they did pick up a win against EDG. It's been such a long time.
Oh,
now
Broxah.
It looks like Tay's going to be making a play here onto Broxah. The Dawning Shadow.
On the bot side of the map is crystal clean, so.
So we know Team Liquid, they can set up this 1-3-1 and impact. The level advantage, you get pulled backwards by the Shockwave, manages to slice and dice, and Ruthless Predator got the Titan, the Tiamat completed as well. And currently looking to be the shining light here on the side of INTZ. He's found himself Jensen, but Core JJ is coming to back up. The Enchanted Crystal Arrow did not find a target. Fantastic death sentence over the wall. Now Tay's running for his life and he's down. INTZ can find
Oh, maybe he's getting arrested.
In the Baron Pit, the Shockwave is available and not yet used. Finally, on the last.
Cast a curse.
That's it, the cast a curse. It's not my fault. Do not blame me.
Sort of threatening engage. Mikal is around. Mikal actually blew both his summoners and Tactical has no arrow, so I think Mikau had to flash away from the arrow. He uses the ult to cancel Brox, and Shinny's
here
as well.
This isn't done yet. Tay keeping the pressure. He's finally going to start to back away the inhibitor turret. Destiny has been used by Jensen. Brox is running for his life. The gate follows through. Gold card lands onto Shinny. Tay has not left the bottom lane.
To use it. Now they don't have TPs. And you said the weak side police, you said Impact was respecting the ball game. He finally gets arrested. He does die.
It's not my fault.
And this is huge for the side of INTZ.
Further shenanigans would play out. A minute and a half until the next Infernal. Remember,
no flash
on tactical Redbert. He gets the headbutt. The pulverized Atlantis available. He's dead. He's done. INTZ find their seventh kill. Now Tay has picked the fight with Impact. He's locked inside the baby cage. The shockwave is still available, and so is Command Protect. Dawning Shadow comes up. Flash forward, shockwave. Shinny gets Impact.
Can they go Baron?
Do they go Baron? Is this the right call?
This is the right call. You can't contest this Baron. The Destiny spots everyone out. You know there's no way you're going to walk
look at
in
this
here.
Now. Tay, he's got the Death Dance completed, and we'll talk about that in a moment. Great engage from Redbird.
Yeah, Tactical's contesting midway, but like I said, Corja Tay wasn't in position to lantern him, and Impact tried to collapse as well. Tay identified it really well, so just two big mistakes from TL. Don't contest midway with no flash and Core JJ's on around, and don't try to collapse when you have no vision, and Tay's first to the play.
Cajal, what I love about that is just, and it will be the second Drake. Sol is going to be a long time away from both teams.
It's a long this way. It's really good 4-1. They move 3-man top side, they take top 2-2. Now they're moving 4-man bot side, kind of holding hands here. Redbird, he might have to ult.
He does indeed. The Unbreakable Will, the Enchanted Crystal Arrow, there's a root catching out Tactical, but they've get the tower. Baron power play.
Everything's kind of clawed back to an even game state, and midwaves is what they kind of need to contest most of the time. You can see Jensen's grouping more.
Oh, look at that engage! Redbird finds Tactical
TP's
in core JJ. Multiple teleports in the mid lane, and that's the root in the back. INTZ have peeled away. Insta-flash from Impact. The Hextech Ultimatum is available, but not yet used.
They need to clear this midwave. I think they should be fine defending this in here, but the dragon's in 50 seconds. Oh, Impact.
It's a good pullback. Impact is
huge shockwave.
Fantastic shockwave. There's no further follow-up. Dawning Shadow is just on cooldown. Dragon forming. And INTZ are the ones making the forward move.
Tactical and Core JJ have no flashes. Brox, I might have to flash here as well. And without flashes, you can't walk up against Orianna.
He goes
golden. If he dies, they can get burned.
I think they're going to. That is a dead Broxer caught out of position. Yeah, there's not a lot of threat just yet. Broxer finally making his way up. The blast cone has already popped.
Redbird.
Destiny has been used. Redbird throws down the Unbreakable Will. Core JJ can Death Sentence and Lantern across. Decides not to. And the Baron easily secured. Now is there... Listen, the 5v5s have gone the way of INTZ over and over and over. INTZ win here will set up that tiebreaker with Mad Lions replicating Estina. That's it. Tactical's dead. He's down. There's nothing he can do against the Envy Shockwave. There is a reinitiation here from Core JJ. He's pulled backwards by the Showstopper. He manages to help set up the kill into the count. But now Core JJ and Impact are trying to do what they can. That's another pullback from Shinny, and Impact will get taken down in a matter of time. The Slice, the Dice, the Ruthless Predator will not be enough. And take a look at that. INTZ are not yet eliminated. INTZ will take down the undefeated Team Liquid, and INTZ will face Mad Lions for a shot at playoffs.
OCL 采访，恭喜 INT 拿下了本场比赛胜利。我们请到的是上单选手 Tay 来到 OCL 采访席。Congratulations, can you say hello to our audience first?
Thank you.
好，非常害羞。首先问一下第一个问题，首先他们是从状态非常非常好的 TL 身上拿到了这一分。其实之前的比赛当中可能看出来状态不是特别的理想，成绩也是。所以说他们是怎么做到的呢？
Vocês ganharam contra um time muito forte da TL e vocês que perderam as partidas. Como que foi a troca de... Como vocês fizeram para voltar para a forma?
O que a gente percebeu nesses últimos jogos que a gente jogou, nos três primeiros, é que a gente estava jogando com muito medo, com muito receio. E como acho que chegou num ponto que acho que ninguém mais acreditava na gente, acho que meio que tirou a pressão do nosso lado e a gente resolveu jogar mais solto, mais confortável assim. Porque eu acho que no Campeonato Mundial, acho que o principal é você jogar sem medo do oponente e sempre ser proativo.
我觉得我们前三场打的不是就打得很小心，不敢打，然后就是因为今天我们已经输了三场，就压力也没那么大，所以我们就说我们放开打，也不要怕对手，我们就赢了。
嗯，其实刚刚也自己有提到嘛，说打放开了打。其实对手的话呢，是以运营为出名的一个队伍。那今天是说可能版本比较适合快节奏，所以笃定了这一点，然后就想着用快攻这种方式去跟对方这样正面刚吗？
A TL é famosa por ser um time de comp de scale. Aí vocês fizeram, vocês souberam isso e pegaram um comp mais de tipo early mid game?
A gente sabia sim que eles jogavam um estilo de jogo mais lento, acho que a maioria dos times norte-americanos jogam assim. Então, e a gente gosta de jogar, sendo muito ativo no começo, sempre buscando luta, etc. Então acho que a gente tinha uma certa vantagem com isso, que é o jeito que a gente gostava de jogar e o jeito que eles não estavam acostumados.
我们都知道北美就喜欢偏运营 的阵容，然后我们自己队是喜欢前期打架的阵容，所以我们相信这是对我们是好的一点，所以我们就打得非常舒服。
嗯，那在这个版本当中呢，其实我们在入围赛也看到，就是很多的选手都表示这是一个 AP 打野特别强的那个版本，然后今天对面也是选出来一个莉莉亚嘛，但是好像说在入围赛阶段我们目前看到的莉莉亚好像效果都不是特别的理想，那他是怎么评价说莉莉亚在当前版本的一个表现呢？
Nessa meta é muito bom para ter jungle AP. Aí, o que tu acha do Champion Lilia em si e em relação à meta?
Eu acho que o Champion Lilia é o jungle mais forte do meta, com certeza. Porque além... Ela basicamente faz tudo. Ela é AP, ela dá bastante dano, ela tem CC, ela faz a jungle rápido. Então, é um champion muito arriscado, assim, de deixar aberto. Mas a gente sabia que eles não gostavam tanto, assim, do champion, que eles pegaram no playoff lá do NA e eles perderam. E acho que no jogo de ontem deles, anteontem, quer dizer, eles quase não deram tanta prioridade assim. Então a gente sabia que mesmo se eles pegassem, eles não estariam tão confortáveis, assim.
我认为莉莉亚确实是版本很厉害的一个英雄，她清野快有控制，而且就节奏非常好。可是我们就是知道的是，他们这战对面战队不太喜欢打这个莉莉亚，即使他们拿了，我们也不会说就不会担心这个点。
嗯，好的，那我们可能在之后的比赛当中要注意一下阵容跟莉莉亚这个英雄搭配的一个问题。那因为下一场呢也是马上就要跟 Matt 加赛了，所以也希望他们能够一切顺利拿下这一分。谢谢你来到我们的赛后采访，Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
那我们赛后采访先到此告一段落。